This is module one, okay, of your syllabus, which is called as basic concepts. Here you will be learning the techniques for simplifying the network and finding INV. When we say basic concepts, it's analysis of a circuit. Analysis of a circuit means finding a current or a voltage in some branch. Understand? Okay, so that is what the basic concept is, and how to simplify the network is what we are going to look at today. I'll be giving you the most basic stuff which you already have learned in your PU or maybe in physics. Okay, so let's see that. So this is all about this network. Means I've told you it's all about RLC. Okay, RLC. But if L and C are introduced, it makes little challenging. It makes the analysis challenging. So let's learn only with R. Okay, circuits only with R. Once we deal with the circuits only with R, okay, once we get good with the techniques, okay, with only the circuits containing R, then we will apply the same techniques to the circuits containing L and C. Okay, the circuits containing only R are called as DC circuits. Understand this. And the circuits which contain all the three, okay, are called as AC circuits. Fine. So we have to understand the techniques by dealing with DC circuits first, because it won't pose the problems that AC circuits pose. Okay, so DC circuits are easier to deal with. Let's consider DC circuits. That means the circuits only with R, and learn all the techniques of network simplification. KVL, KCL, there's something called as mesh analysis, known as, all that we'll learn taking DC circuits. That means the circuits involving only R. Then once we become good with that, then we will go with the circuits containing L and C also, which are referred to as AC circuits. Understand? So let's begin. What are the techniques that I'm, very, very simple techniques. We all know what if there are resistors in series, right? Resistor in series. Everybody just copy this, the basics I'm giving. How the resistors in series would look like. See here, this is one resistor, two resistor, three resistors. Fine. Now this is suppose R1, R2 and R3. Now these two terminals, let's call them as terminals AB. Fine. If terminals AB have got the three resistors in series, okay, what is the equivalent resistance RAB between these two terminals? The question. RAB means it's the resistance across these two points. Understand? What is RAB? What is RAB? RAB is series. You have to add all the resistors. R1 plus R2 plus R3. So this is series connection. Okay. Now what if the resistors are in parallel? Resistors in parallel. Okay. Suppose there are two resistors, say R1 and R2. So this is what is parallel connection all about. So suppose if you take them as a resistor with two, what, leads here. The resistor has got two leads. Okay. One lead should go and catch with the one lead of the other resistor, and the remaining leads should also join together. Okay, so this should happen for parallel connection. because sometimes if you are not aware of what is parallel connection, people will sometimes mistake the series connection with parallel connection. Okay, whether R1 and R2 are in series or parallel cannot be told unless we mark these terminals AB. Unless we mark these terminals AB, we cannot say whether R1 and R2 are in series or not. Okay, just I'll give you that. I'll just tell you. Suppose I say R1 and R2. Okay, how R1 and R2 are connected? Anybody? How R1 and R2 are connected? Somebody should come out with the answer. How R1 and R2 are connected?
Series, yeah. Sir.
Okay, series. Hold on. Whoever has answered, hold on. Okay. Now, let's do this. Now, can you tell me how R1 and R2 are connected?
Series itself, sir.
No. Listen here. Unless I tell you across which two terminals, you cannot say the equivalent resistors. Suppose if I write the same like this. Now, are they in series or in parallel? There is confusion, isn't it? It is the same circuit, see here?
Yes, sir.
We cannot say series or parallel. Why we cannot say series or parallel? We are not seeing any of these terminals out across which we find our resistances. Getting that point, unless I give you the two terminals across which you have to tell the equivalent resistance, you cannot say whether R1 and R2 are in series or parallel. Okay, so if you see this, you will say series. If you see this, you will say they are in parallel. So unless I give you the terminals, okay, you cannot say whether they are in series in parallel. Okay, just listen to my statement here. Suppose I give my terminals here. Okay, now how R1 and R2 are connected? There are two branches. One branch is this, another branch is this. There is no resistance. The resistance is zero here. Everybody understand how R1 and R2 are connected? Anybody?
In series, sir.
Yeah. Now R1 and R2 are in series. If I do this, how are these R1 and R2 are connected now? They are in parallel. Yeah. You should understand. That means looking at the terminals, you can say, if the terminals are not given, you should ask across which two points you are referring to, sir. Anybody for that matter, if they ask you given two resistors, okay, and if they ask you whether these resistors are in series or parallel, you should say, so where are the terminals? Get this point, everybody? So you should ask for this question. Where are the terminals? Okay, unless you understand where the terminals are being taken, you cannot answer whether the resistors are in series or in parallel. Is everybody okay with that? Okay, now what is this parallel resistance equal to? What is this parallel resistance equal to? Anybody? These are all your PUC stuff, right? Yeah. Tell me now, what is RAB when they are parallel? We can write it like this. See here? So this implies that. Yeah. This implies that our RAB can be given by, see, it's RAB equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. This is how we can tell what RAB is. So therefore, from this, RAB implies what? R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Now, just for information, if there are three resistors like this, let's say, in parallel, 1, 2, and 3 resistors in parallel, they're all holding their hands, okay, with one another. They're all holding their hands. One bunch of one pair, one hand will come all together, the other hand will go all together. Okay, that is what parallel connection is. We can always talk of two people here. See, suppose there are two persons like this. Fine, if they hold these hands, they are in series. This is series connection. Okay, when they hold this hand also, another hand also together, and you have these terminals here, then they'll become parallel. Okay, both the hands should be engaged. Get that connection? Okay, fine. Now, what I wanted to give you here is this. See, yeah? Suppose this is R1, R2, and R3. Fine. Let's call this as X and Y terminals. What is RXY? RXY is RXY R1, R2, R3 divided by R1 plus R2 plus R3, anybody? Since RAB, when there are two resistors in parallel, is R1, R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So when there are three resistors, do you think that would become this? Anybody?
No, sir.
No. So you should not mistake this. Okay? So this is right. Fine. So this is not right. So if you have to find out RXY, what you would do? You would do this. RXY is 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This is right. This is right. But this is not. Okay. So let's be a little careful when we are dealing with this. Now, this is series and parallel connections. Now, it is not only about this. Your network analysis or network theory is not only about finding the equivalent resistors. What else we need to look at? We also need to look at the voltages and the currents. Everybody understand that? We need to look at the voltages and currents also. So when would there be a current flow in the circuit? When the voltage is applied. Everybody understand that? When a voltage is applied, there could be a current flow. Otherwise, no current flow. No voltage, no current. Understand that? So let's look at some basic circuits by applying the voltage now. Fine. So what are that we are learning here? First, we learned what if there are resistors in series. What if there are resistors in parallel? They're all basic concepts. Something that we have already learned, but again, we are revisiting that. Fine. Now what we shall do is this third one. Okay. What we're doing, let's say there is a current flowing in the series. So R1 and R2 are in series. Okay. Now what I'm doing across this, I'm applying a voltage source. Fine. This is also voltage source. This is called as DC voltage. Okay, the frequency is not that. This is called DC voltage. So say even this is DC voltage. Say everybody listen to here. This is also a DC voltage, or the same thing is denoted by a large terminal and a small line. Okay, what does that mean? This is plus, this is minus. You can write anything. Fine. So this is also a voltage source. This is also a voltage source. So both are DC sources. So when do we connect AC sources? We connect AC sources when we deal with L and C. Okay, they're all DC sources. So this is a DC voltage source with voltage V. Understand? Plus or minus is already written. So this is a voltage source. So when a voltage source is applied, the current flows through. It comes out of this positive terminal. Okay, so this is I flowing in the circuit. Is everybody okay with this? Now, see here, I'll take out the participants. I'll be calling out Zeeshan. Zeeshan, can you unmute? Zeeshan?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Now tell me, Zeeshan, there is a current flowing, yes, right? Do you think the same current flows through R1 and R2? Do you think the same current flows through R1 and R2? Yeah. So which means that just stay there without muting. So the same I is flowing through R1 and R2. Everybody get this point? So that means when the resistors are in series, the same current flows through both the resistors. Is this clear? Okay. Now, okay, Zeeshan, you can mute. Neha, can you come out now? Neha, can you unmute? Neha, can you unmute? If you don't do that fast, that will take a lot of time. Neha, not there. Neha, KM. Okay, Neha, KR. Neha, KR, can you unmute? Yeah. Neha, now the current which is flowing through this is same. What is about the voltage? What is about the voltage? Not audible. It is different. How we can say it is different? Suppose say this voltage is 5 volts. Let's say this is 5 volts. Okay. Now R1 is 1 ohm. R2 is 1 ohm. Okay. So what would be the voltages across this? Okay, let me tell that you can mute yourself. See here, this 5 volts is there, right? Because of 5 volts being applied, the current is flowing. Since resistors are in series, the same current flows. Fine. What happens to this voltage? This voltage has to drop across these two resistors. One voltage drop should come here, the other voltage drop should come here. And since both the resistors are same, we can say this voltage gets equally divided into two parts. One part would come here, the other part would come here. Everybody is okay with that? I repeat, resistors in series, the same current flows, but voltage gets divided. One part of the voltage would come here, the other part of the voltage would go here. Everybody is okay with that? Okay, so what we can write if since let's write that. Same current I flows through both the resistors because they are in series. Flows through both R1 and R2. Both R1 and this is just for your reference, okay? Both R1 and R2, since they are in series. But voltage gets divided. But voltage gets applied, voltage gets divided. Okay. So what does that mean? See here, if R1 is equal to R2, okay, So let's call this. Let's just remove all these values. Okay. Just let's remove this. Now let's say the voltage across R1 is V1. Voltage across R2 is V2. So if R1 and R2 are equal, then V1 is equal to V2. Fine. Now, when R1 is greater than R2, again I am coming to you. Okay. Now, Nesara, can you unmute yourself? Nesara, there.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Nesara, tell me what happens to the voltages. R1 is greater than R2. What should happen to V1 and V2? Just tell me which voltage would be greater. This R1 is greater than R2. So tell me V1 is greater or V2 is greater?
V1 will be smaller, V2 will be greater.
R1, that means you mean to say smaller voltage drop is there across larger resistance?
Is sir, that what? R1 less than, V1 less than V2.
V1 less than V2, I'm saying R1 is greater than R2. So, understand this. If the more is the resistance, more is the drop. Nesra, understand this. More is the resistance, more is the drop. Less is the resistance, less is the drop. Understand that? Okay. See here?
Okay, sir.
So when R1 is greater than R2, then we can say V1 would also be greater than
V2.
V2. That means larger is the resistance, larger is the drop. Okay? So let's write that.
Okay,
now.
Sir.
Let's write that now. Understand this. What is that? We have to understand here is note larger the resistance, okay, larger the voltage drop. Everybody is okay with that? Now I'll just give you this. Everybody, see here, I'll give you an example. Let's see if we'll be able to do that. Yeah. Example. Okay. Now there are two resistors. Fine. I'm applying the voltage. Okay, let's say this is 1 ohm and this is 2 ohms, and what I have applied is say 10 volts. Fine. Now, can you tell me what is the current flow here? What is I given by, or what is V? V is equal to IR. Fine. So this implies that our I is V by R. What is V? V is the applied voltage. And what is R? R is the resistance 1, 2 having been connected in series. So it is 1 plus 2. What happens to this? The current becomes 10 by 3 amps. Get this. Now, if current flowing is 10 by 3, the same current 10 by 3 flows through this, 10 by 3 flows through this. Okay. Can you now give me V1 and V2? Can you give me V1 and V2? You know the current flow. So what is V1 given by? So therefore, V1 is, So therefore, V1 is what? V is equal to IR. So IR, right? So I into R. So what is I? I is 10 by 3. What is R? R is 1 ohm. So V1 is what? 10 by 3 volts. Fine. So similarly, V2 is also IR. Okay. 10 by 3 is the same current flowing. What's happening to the resistance is 2. So that means what it would become? It would become 20 by 3 volts. So which is greater now? So this implies that since R2 is greater than R1, okay, we can say V2 is greater than V1. Understand? See, what we need to observe here is this implies, therefore, larger is R, larger is V. Okay, see, yeah, larger is R. Where is this R? V2. V2 is 20 by 3, V1 is 10 by 3. So that means 10 by 3 comes across 1 ohm, 20 by 3 comes across 2 ohms. Is everybody okay with this? Fine. Now, there is another shortcut method to find out this V1 and V2. That is called as voltage division rule. When would voltage be getting divided? Everybody understand. When would voltage get divided? Voltage would get divided when the resistors are in series. Everybody should understand this. What am I saying? Voltages get divided when the resistors are in series. Fine. So V1 and V2 can also be calculated by voltage division rule. Okay. V1 and V2 can also be calculated by voltage division rule. Anybody who knows the voltage division rule, this is something that you have seen, maybe, I don't know. Anybody know what is voltage division rule? How I can give my V1? V1 is total voltage applied into resistance R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Everybody understand that? See here, V1 is given by total voltage applied, that is this V, okay, into the resistance of the branch where V1 is dropping divided by sum of the resistances. Okay, so let's see what is this going to be equal to. What is the applied voltage? What is applied voltage? Applied voltage is 10 volts. What is R1? R1 is 1. Okay, here R1 is 1, R2 is 2. So what is this? 10 by, oh, what's happening here? 10 by 3. So see, V1 is 10 by 3. So can you similarly give me V2? Can you similarly give me V2? I'll ask somebody to do that. Whom I shall ask? Shall I ask Nitish? Yes, K. Can you unmute yourself, boy? Nitish? Nitish SK, can you unmute? Those who know can start doing that yourselves. Voltage division rule. Nitish SK is not there. So people, if they are not unmuting, maybe I have to see what is wrong with you. Nitin? Nitish SK is not unmuting. Nitin? Nitin, you are there? No. Pawan? Is Pawan there? So if you are not unmuting, it means that you are not there. So just log in and move out. Fine. Anybody who would like to volunteer?
Sir, V into R2 by R1 plus R2.
Who's speaking? Who's speaking? Suhana is speaking. Okay, Suhana, yes, tell sir. Me. Tell me, Suhana. It is?
V into? R2 by? R1 plus R2.
Good. So V is the applied voltage, that is 10. Okay. So R2 is 2 divided by 1 plus 2. That will give you 20 by 3 volts. So by voltage division rule also we can find out the voltages is what I wanted to give you. Fine. Now, similarly, whatever we have seen now. So this we have seen for series resistances and applied voltage across the series resistance. Fine. Now let's see the same scenario for the parallel resistors. Understand that? Okay. So that is our fourth technique that we'll be discussing. Take down. The fourth technique we are discussing is you have two resistors, R1 and R2. Fine. Then you have the voltage being applied here, plus minus. Fine. So this is R1 and this is R2. This is applied voltage. Soon after the voltage is applied, the current starts flowing here. Okay. And see what happens to current after it comes here is the question. So this current after it comes here has to get divided into two parts. See, one part would flow through R1. The other part will flow through R2. Everybody is okay with this? This current which is flowing in this particular branch, okay, after coming here has to get divided into two parts. Why only two parts? Because there are two branches coming out. If there are three branches coming out, the current would get divided into three parts. Get that? Now, one current would flow through R1. So let's call that current as I1. The current that is flowing through R2, let's call that as I2. Fine. Now the same I1 would come here and the same I2 would come here. Again, they get combined to give us I. So what is this I? This I is I1 plus I2, mind you. The currents which split initially would again get combined here. Okay. The I1 and I2 are divided currents. Those divided currents would again combine because again these two branches are coming together. So again I starts flowing. So whichever currents leaves this terminal, the same current should enter. That means see, I is leaving this voltage terminal. The same I should come back, mind you. So this is the rule. Is everybody okay with this? The I which left the positive terminal of the battery, okay, the same I will return to that negative terminal of the battery is what one should understand. The current is getting divided here, whereas in series connection, the voltage was getting divided, okay. In parallel connection, the current is getting divided. Understand that? Now, let's make the same analysis. Okay. If R1 and R2 are, what analysis did we make here? See, yeah? If R1 and R2 are same, what would happen? If R1 is greater than R2, what would happen is what we are looking at here also. Okay. There we were interested in voltage because voltage was getting divided in series connection. Here the current is getting divided. That's why we are interested in current. What would be the voltage across R1 and R2? Suppose you have, I'll just say this is V1 and this is V2. What is V1 and V2, anybody? What is V1 and V2? See here, if there are parallel connection, okay, the two voltages would be equal to the applied voltage. Fine. Similarly, here, suppose I call the current, similarly, let's see, what is I1 then? So what is I1? I1 and I2 can be seen when R1 is equal to R2, okay, I1 is equal to I2. Fine. Similarly, when R1 is greater than R2, so when R1 is greater than R2 means this R1 is offering more resistance than R2. So more the resistance, less is the current here. More the resistance, more is the voltage. More the resistance, less is the current. So in that sense, if R1 is greater than R2, I1 has to be, anybody? I1 has to be, since R1 is greater than R2, R1 is offering more resistance. If R1 is offering more resistance, obviously R2 is offering less resistance. I1 has to be less than I2, mind you. Less than. R1 is greater than, it is offering more resistance. More is the resistance offered, less is the current flow. Understand? Okay. More is the resistance, more is the voltage drop. But more is the resistance, less is the current flow. Why is that happen? C is equal to V is equal to IR, is there, right? This V is equal to IR is true for constant resistance, mind you. If resistance is constant, what would happen? We have to maintain the equilibrium here. So that means if this is increasing, okay, this has to reduce. Get that point? Okay. So V is equal to